You know, this is Pastor Wallace. We're so glad you tuned in today, amen, to the Word of Victory broadcast. It's going to be good. Listen, you got to pay attention. I want you to hear what is being said, amen. Why? Because the Word is going to give you the victory. Let's go right now to the broadcast.
Hi, this is Taylor. I am hosting for the Word of Victory Youth. And today I am with
Brandon.
And today we're just going to be talking about the struggle of like high school and stuff that goes on in high school of in his generation. So as you being in high school and stuff, like, I know you just told me you're 17.
Yeah.
And what do you see or like, what do you witness in your school or outside of school at your age?
Like people my age, that what they're not supposed to be doing.
Yeah.
Like, they sneak out, do drugs, stuff like that. Like, they don't do the work, don't come to school, like, skip, talk, like, back to their parents, like, just don't have a care.
Right. So, like, when you see people that, like, that do that, right?
Yeah.
I know you don't do it,
yeah,
but...
not like that.
Yeah, but would you, like, do you think that them doing that, it would be more of a good decision for them to lead themselves through Christ, just to not, you know, put themselves in that type of predicament or anything?
Yeah, I think, yeah, follow Christ, they'll, like, be way better.
Yeah. Yeah, because I think that, like, stuff that's happening and other people, well, not other people, but teenagers that's even older, that's in their, that's like at least 17, 18 and up, could be doing the same things that us young kids that's like 14, 13, doing things that they're not supposed to be doing, like taking drugs, sneaking out, doing things that they don't have no business doing, instead just doing what's right and what you need to be doing at your age.
At the same time, I think like that comes like from their home.
Yeah.
Like, not having like role models.
Or right.
Someone like to follow, laying the right steps.
Yeah, because, you know, some young kids can pick up off what they see and what they grow up from. So they're just going to
do what they see.
Yep. Right. But, you know, so it's always make sure that you have a person in your life that is close to God and can help you become closer to God and build that bond with Him, because, you know, you'll never know when something will happen or what will happen, and God will always be with you through anything. He will keep looking over you, watching over you, making sure that you are safe and where you need to be doing what you are. So, in the future, where do you see yourself being at? Like, what do you want to do when you just hit that stage where you're just an adult?
I just want to have like a like set life, like,
yeah,
be successful, like don't have to be like worrying about nothing,
yeah,
like no legal troubles or anything like that. Yeah. Just everything the right way, like that.
Yeah, and what you mean by being successful? Like, what do you
like,
want to
like do? Financially and like just financially.
Okay, okay. And I want to do the same thing, actually. I want to be successful in my life too. And this one time I was leaving from school and I had told this lady that I wanted to be a pastor. She said that young kids my age don't ever think of wanted to be doing that at such a young age.
Yeah.
And I was surprised, but at the same time I wasn't, because I know that some kids my age don't really find the interest and the fun of being one. But she had told me that some pastors don't make a lot of money from doing it, but I don't think I would be caring about the money. I would just be thinking about, like, helping others,
yeah,
get close to God and worshiping Him and praising Him through your whole life, just to when it's your time that you get you get put in a place of heaven and not in hot place that you don't want to be placed in.
Yeah. Like, I think like pastor is not about the money. It's like just helping people.
Yeah.
Like help them get closer with God.
And yeah.
Just reach their full potential.
So do you feel like you have a relationship with God, or like do you feel like you have God in your life?
Yeah, I feel like I have God in my life. Like over the years my relationship has got stronger. I feel like it could be way stronger than what it is right now.
Yeah.
But that's what I'm working towards right now.
Me too. I am working towards building a closer bond with God, because you know the devil could be working. He would work so hard for you not to have that close bond with him. And it's hard to just focus on God, and you then it's like something is triggering you to not put your full potential on him or your love. And it's just that one thing that's holding you back. But, you know, you just got to keep in your mind and keep in your heart that God has you. God is your current to life. God will help you be better than what you want to be. You know, like, God is everything. So,
yeah.
So, what ways do you think you can, like, get that close bond with God?
Think like it starts like going to church.
Yeah.
Like I just started going to church like more again.
Mm-hmm.
Like praying to him like every day, things like that.
Yeah.
And like just try to find like the positives in things, and like yeah, he's the cause of it.
So when you do that, or like when you start to think of doing that, do you think it's hard, easy for that to, you know, do?
It's not easy, but it's not hard. You just gotta put yourself in there and try to do it.
So, yeah, I agree too, because it's not. And it's a lot of temptations with that and stuff. And you just gotta try to get that bond with God. It's not to let that, let the devil just take what you're trying to get, or what you're trying to get at, because God knows what you truly want and need and what you crave for, and it's not what's trying to make you fall from what you don't need. So people at your age, do you think that they need to lead themselves to Christ? Not need, but they should. Do you recommend them to lead themselves to Christ?
Yeah, I think everyone should.
Yeah.
Like, if you want to have, like, a better life, you should lead yourself to Christ.
Yeah, I agree. Because without having Christ in your life, then it wouldn't be such of a great life. You will have some up and downs in between. And keeping God in your life, it just makes your whole life feel more, you know, better and more to live for. And then, but it just be other things that be trying to take you away from Christ.
Yeah.
But you gotta fight that. You gotta not let that stuff make you distance from Jesus. Let Jesus guide you through what you need to get through, and let him make your life become good from what it needs to be. So, do you have a question for me?
Not really.
Okay.
Oh, so back to school, do you see, like, people, like, in, like, your age, like, doing, like, things they're not supposed to be doing?
Yeah, I definitely do. From what you said when I asked you that question, I would say the same thing. I do feel like that people my age do. I do feel like they got Christ and Jesus in their life, but they're not taking it consideration. They're not really focusing on God. They just want to do what they want to do. And I feel like they do know God's in their life, but it's just something that distracts them from wanting to put their all or wanting to focus on all only him and just him. So I know it'd be a little weird.
At the same time, I think people, like, they're, like, scared.
Yeah.
Like, to show. Like, they, like, care what other people think and stuff. Kind of, like, stuff like that.
Yeah, I think that, like, they care what other people think when it comes to God. They think that, some people think that being closer to God or just believing in God is a religion. But to me, I think it's just like trying to get a, build a relationship or build a bond with God and make sure to let yourself know that God, that you are safe and you and your only love that you need from someone is God and only God. And yeah, so I'm pretty sure he's gonna edit this.
Huh?
So I'm pretty sure he's gonna edit this.
Oh, okay.
But
do you feel like there was a time like you needed God and he came? Like,
yeah.
Did you need him?
Yeah. Oh yeah, I do. There was multiple times where I needed God and he did come. I feel like every time I pray to him and communicate with him through my prayers, he do answer my prayers. Not in a fast of a urge. It takes time. You need patience for God to answer your prayers and for him to let you know that he sees you and he hears you. And by the time God did answer my prayers, I had prayed and I asked him for him to reveal who in my bubble is who he don't want me to be around. And I asked that he isolate me from others that he don't want me to be around, and that he just give me peace, because I feel like when I'm with other people, they don't see the God and the child of God in me. And I feel like when I'm around them, they give off and bring off negativity. So I just ask God to give me that peace and isolation from those type of people, because I don't want to keep falling in the devilness, things that the devil wants me to bring. I don't want to be falling in. I just want to, when people look at me, I just want them to see the child of God in me, the Christianity, the, this girl love God, and I do love God. I love him with my whole heart. I just want people to see that in me. And when God answered my prayers and he isolated me from the people, I felt more relieved. I felt happy. And then, like, people would be coming up to me like, oh, you're fake, you don't talk to me no more. Or it's like, they'd be like, you're focusing on one thing and you're not focusing on me. Well, I am, because I'm focusing on God and I'm trying to get my bond with him and build with him. And doing that, I feel happy. You know, I'm not, you know, there's no negativity around me. It's all positivity, it's all peace, it's all love. It feel good just being with God and loving him. And knowing that he got you and that he will forever have your angels guarded around you. So to answer your question, yes. So do you feel like he did for you? Like, did he come to answer your prayers or anything?
Like, all the time. Like, it's not like just one specific time. It's just like everyday thing. Daily basis thing.
Okay. Yeah. So, when he did answer your prayers, you know, how did you feel? How does that make you feel?
Like, I was relieved. Like, he's actually listening to me.
Yeah.
Like, he's actually there. Like, that just made me want to be closer with him.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Because God gonna always answer your prayers. And if you think he isn't, he will. He are. It takes time and patience. You can't rush for God to answer what you truly want or need, you know? And he's just not going to give you that in a snap of a finger. Yeah. You got to earn that. You got to work towards that. You got to put in a work. You got to worship him. You got to praise him. there's no free handouts, you know? So when it comes to God, yeah. So,
next topic.
Yeah, next topic.
Okay. I don't know.
So, you know, you said you try, or you do be trying to build yourself to Christ or build a relationship with God.
Yeah.
Do you recommend to, like, do that with your friends? Do you have any friends that you recommend to build themselves to God too?
Yeah, I have a couple.
And you think that would be a good decision for them to do?
Yeah.
I think so too. But I
think it's in their best interest.
Yeah.
Is he gonna cut some parts out?
Oh,
there's so much time.
I can't think of nothing.
Can we like talk about anything?
Yeah.
Or do you have like any goals for next year, like upcoming year?
Yes, I do.
Or like or to end off this year that you need to complete or have completed?
I had a couple goals I do want to complete and work towards too. I struggle with a lot of things like a sin, and you know, it's not hard to let go of a sin that you are really, you know, really hold on to, and you know deep down that you want to let go of that sin, but you just can't because of what it comes with. And I know that God wants me to stop doing that certain sin, and I just feel it, but you know, when I pray, I ask that he just help me get away from that sin and repent from it. And I ask for forgiveness every single time I pray to him. I ask that he just help me just remove from that sin and not let me keep sinning while I'm trying to build a bond with him. Because I do feel like when I talk to God, it's like, and I ask him to do stuff for me, he just doesn't do it because I know that I'm sinning while trying to get closer to him. And you know, you can't serve two masters. And I know one master I want to be with, and that's God, Jesus Christ himself. But it's just this one sin that's taking what I want to move forward to and what I truly love and what I desire, and that is God. But just the devil is working and working and working. So for me, I just need to keep praying. I'm going to keep praying and praying. I'm going to keep trying my best to worship him, praise him. I'm going to do that, actually. I'm going to keep worshiping him, praising him, talking about God, bringing him up in every situation with my friends and everything, just so that I can get the sin off me and have that good bond and closer bond with Jesus Christ. And I know that I have God in my life, but I want to feel like that I just have him. I feel his presence and everything. I feel his presence when I'm praying and talk to him and communicate with him. I just want to feel his presence out doing that. I just want to feel him. And that's one of my goals. Another goal is to accomplish in school and stay to myself, keep the peace that God gave me to myself, and keep the isolation to myself too, and not make any new friends that will put me in that negative spirit, negative energy I don't want to be around. And you know, keep leading myself to Christ and making sure that the people around me is also lead through Christ, and I use that power that God gave me to encourage people to lead themselves through Christ and worship God and praise Him through any and everything and in your life forever. So is there any goals that you are looking forward to accomplish currently or next year?
The goal I'm working on is like finishing high school.
Yeah, okay.
I want God like to help me like finish and like get like, I want to get accepted in like all my colleges mm-hmm. I apply for. And another goal I have is trying to keep my like circle small, mm-hmm. smaller than what it is. Yeah. Like I got a feeling like I need to make it smaller. Mm-hmm. I just got to keep asking God. Yeah.
Yeah, I want to backpack on that, because, you know, when you do ask God to make your circle smaller, you know, when He make it smaller, you're going to realize at some point that you really don't need anybody but Him.
Yeah.
Yeah, and, you know, I'm still trying to learn. I'm still trying to learn from that, and sometimes it do get lonely, and, you know, not lonely. Yeah, lonely. Just a little lonely, and, just let down, but then I keep reminding myself and letting myself know that I have God and I'm not alone. I have God and I love Him, and I will keep on just building that bond with Him. So when you do complete high school, when you finish high school and you go to a college,
mm-hmm.
And is there a specific college that you want to go to?
So I'm looking at two certain colleges right now, Eastern Michigan and Grand Valley.
Okay. Yeah, I want to go to Grand Valley too.
They're like my top two choices right now.
Yeah.
I got accepted in Eastern. I'm just waiting on Grand Valley right now.
That's what's up. And which between those two, though, which one do you actually want to go to?
It's hard. It's like my one and two. It's like 1A, 1B. So, but whatever one like gives me a better opportunity, honestly.
Yeah. I do like Grand Valley, and when I went there to go to the college and look through the college and look at the classes and stuff, it was real nice, and I really liked it. And they had gave me a free scholarship to their college when I was an upcoming high schooler. And I really appreciate them for that, because I know that God made it work and it happened in His hands. And without God, I wouldn't have that scholarship for that college that I wanted to go to, because I was really stuck. I didn't know what college I wanted to go to. I didn't know nothing about no colleges. I know I wanted to go to Wayne State. But everybody go there, and
everybody go to Grand Valley now.
Yeah, everybody go to Grand Valley. But I don't know. I've been on Grand Valley since I was a eighth grader. Yeah. I got that scholarship. Yes.
You're a sophomore now?
Yes, I am a sophomore.
Okay.
And I thank God for that, because without God, you know, nothing will be possible. But with Him, everything's possible. Everything will be all right. Everything will be just fine. Everything will be okay. And you be successful in life. God will make sure you be successful in life. God have plans for you. And God got you, whatever you go through. Whatever you need to get through, whatever you want done, whatever you want to be in life, God got that.
Yep.
So,
circling back to goals, mm-hmm. Do you have, like, any goals for, like, your sports?
Yeah.
This year?
Yeah. Well, I don't really like sports.
You don't like sports?
I do, but I don't. I like to play basketball just a little bit. It's just a little confusing because it's just a lot of stuff you got to do. And I'm not a basketball type of girl, but in high school, I just gotta keep myself busy. And
yeah, that's real.
I'm in 10th grade now, and the high school I go to now, I want to go to Votech, but I can't do Votech unless I'm a junior, but I'm a sophomore now. So I just want to keep myself busy with basketball. And I was thinking about cheer, but the girls on the cheer team, they're not my cup of tea to hang around or be cordial with. So I chose basketball, but I found out that basketball is not my cup of tea with the girls on there too. It's really not, hey, I gotta make sure, I just let God be in a situation that, yeah. I just let God handle any situation that I be put in during that, because I just know that the devil will take over me if I was to feed in into that. And I know one time I did just put everything in my hands and things went wrong this one time, but then I just had to pray to God and talk to him like, God, next time I do need to put you in these situations that I put myself in, or will other people put myself in their situation, I do need to put you in a situation, because I don't make it no better for me but worse. But when I put you in them situations, you make it better for me and you handle it correctly than what I can. So I advise y'all to do the same thing. But with basketball, I do see a couple goals. Last year when I was playing for freshman year, I sucked so bad. I didn't know how to do nothing. I didn't know how to dribble between my legs. I didn't know how to shoot nothing. So I was practicing. I kept practicing, but it wasn't a 24/7 thing. I just kept doing it. And for my sophomore year, I got a little better, and I know how to do a couple moves and stuff like that. But I feel like I know how to do that through God. God helped me be better in what sport I want to continue doing. What about you?
So I just finished my senior year, and it's my last year playing football.
Okay.
The year didn't go how we wanted to, but it was God's plan.
Yes, always God's plan.
Hey, I just gotta accept it.
But yes, God will help you through anything, guys, and he'll make sure that you gotta get through what you gotta get through and make sure that you accomplish all your goals in life. But that's all that we have for the Victory Youth channel. Thank you for tuning in, and we'll be back. Bye.
Hey, did you enjoy it? Wasn't it wonderful? Hey, man, the word of victory is good, and it's there for you. Hey, man, you just have to use it, because the word of victory is for us. Listen, I want you to know that you can tune in, amen, every time we're on. And remember, if you want to give to the ministry, there's different ways you can give. There's PayPal. There is Gilify. There is Cash App. And we want you to know, you'll see everything at the end of this broadcast. Remember, come back and see us again. Why? Because there's a miracle with your name on it, and it's waiting on you.